Open Channeling of the Dragons, November 2019. It's happening, humans. You are approaching the Omega point, the point of no return, the event horizon, the point you cannot see beyond. You have for some years been circling around the black hole, so to speak. But now you are there. You are fully on the precipice. You are standing, gazing down into the abyss with your pretensions and ideas of yourselves no longer serving you. How to solve it, how to piece your puzzle together, crush this conundrum that you are choking by. Well, we would advise you to set yourselves free. Of the many words we could explain in that hollow statement, we choose the one free. What is freedom to you humans? Freedom to you is a different type of enslavement. It is the amassing of wealth, or rather, the processing of wealth. What you consider freedom, you tend to equate with your concept of success. Success meaning something to the effect that you are able to garner a great deal of attention and material resources, and then expend these casually and arbitrarily. This seems to be what you dream of as a reward for human existence and a life lived well. What what you dream of then is prosperity. But you do not need to go far into your own wisdom to realize that these things bind you as much as they enable you to change. Change is to us the only currency worth accepting. The ability to sustain change through integration and conscious reorganization of your own nature. This is achieved through a different set of physical and metaphysical labors. These concepts are not adequate, but you could return to your idea of trials, self-imposed restrictions. Set upon yourself to exactly free the instincts that are trying to surface within you. For a long time, instincts were demonized in human culture, and they are instinctually, so to speak, still viewed with a great deal of suspicion. But your instincts are what serves you. Notice your highest and most sublime instinct is the instinct of breath. That is to say, the instinct of spirit, of expiring, perspiring, inspiring, aspiring. It is important to go through these types of breaths within your system. Only by becoming conscious of your own energies will you achieve the type of freedom which your soul will be satisfied by. Living through, you will not get there by any energy absorbed from any unnatural force. That is to say, the type of energy you have been circulating on your planet for the past centuries and that is now destroying it is the energy of lack. As we have went into, this has taught you a great deal, and there is wisdom in lack. However, what happens when you interact with these cultural codes? What you may know as mimetic codes or the simulacral things repeating itself in, let us say, almost fractals of kitsch, losing more and more value, losing more and more what you call authenticity or aura or simply genuine spirit. When things lose those values, they live off the energy you feed them. Remember the next time you are listening to a pop song, you are feeding energy into a dark hole. This is the negative side of the reptilian agenda we have been warning you about. And we are coming through along with our allies in the Galactic Council to counsel humanity into different ways of living and accessing their energy. We too wish for the dark to find the light, so the light can cuddle the dark. We are lizards, but we love. We are dragons, but we too enjoy the arts of fine creation. Seek those out, humans. And there you will find your instincts fused with your angelic natures, and you will be transformed through the creation of your own shining image. May this image be a torch, and may its flame light your days and nights. Peace, honor.